of the rain and snow, even some thunderstorms out there. Up to the north is where we're seeing the transition of the rain and the lower elevations to snow up in the high country here. This is covering up the Hemis Mountains, stretching out towards that northwest plateau as well. But as I zoom you down to the Albuquerque Metro, this is that storm that we're watching, bringing some small hail to areas of the west side, some lightning up near Rio Rancho as well, and heavy rainfall dropping visibility in the area. These storms are passing north, so that's going to be the general direction for the next few hours. And of course, we're going to keep tabs on that. More of the 90s down across central and southern New Mexico, even triple digits in the southeast. 80s up over the northern mountains, 70s and 80s in the northwest. So it's going to be another hot night.
This guy.
We missed you, Adam.
And I missed you.
In celebration, because I know you've been waiting for this all week, right, Curry?
What?
It's Dance Friday.
Oh, boy. I'm glad I came back for the Friday dance.
You should have waited for Monday.
I know. Your dance skills have come so far, Adam. I'm so proud of you.
I've always had them, Kristen. It's just
you just helped bring
them out.
It is an honor to see those in most areas, even potentially nearing 70 miles per hour up in mountain areas. And it's not just today. Tomorrow too, looking at wind gusts about 45 to 50 miles per hour. So that's going to knock us around. It is not a surprise to see the high wind warnings in orange stretched across the majority of New Mexico. High wind winter storm bringing very heavy rainfall and snowfall to portions of the Pacific Northwest and inner mountain west here. As Fernanda mentioned, anywhere from 5 even up to 7 feet of snow possible within the Sierra Nevadas.
I'm going to check on that forecast. Kristen Curry's live at Balloon Fiesta Park. Kristen, how's it looking out there?
Not too bad. A little soggy though, Crystal. Nothing says volume in your hair like humidity over 75%. I'll tell you that.
I was going to say that, but I mean, you know it already.
Yeah. I've seen better days, that's for sure. But it's Balloon Fiesta. We're excited about it. We're excited to be out here and really weather looking a little bit more favorable for launch. We still have the yellow flag. They're currently in pilot's briefing, but we'll see what they come up with.
On by tomorrow. So 7-day forecast does show sunshine here in the metro from now through Sunday. Temperatures warming through the weekend in those lower 70s. And then by early to middle of next week, here comes our next big weather maker, bringing back the chance for rain and some cooler temperatures. Those low 60s coming in by the afternoon of Halloween. So I'll keep you updated on that. For now, we'll send things to Crystal. Let's stop this, zoom it down, and show you where the rain and snow is falling now. Most of McKinley and Cibola County looking at some showers at this moment. As far as the intensity goes, it's certainly enough to slow you down out on the roadways. Maybe some light accumulations, especially on the grassy surfaces. So I would factor in extra minutes for the morning commute for sure. Even out there in Kamado, we're looking at more of the rain and snow showers. Rain for the lower elevation.
Rains in California.
Yeah, David, it's both those storms that we have eyes on. I first wanted to start with that nor'easter that Crystal was mentioning. You can see it doesn't look nearly as impressive as what it did 24 hours ago, but still watching for some moderate to heavy snowfall along coastal Maine down towards New York. This is going to be the last day of this storm system before it eventually kicks off to the northeast. So now our focus is the heavy rainfall over portions of California. And from 96 today, it's down to those upper 80s Friday and Saturday, which is where we should be for this time of year. So we'll keep you up updated on that severe storm threat we have in northeast New Mexico today.
I can honestly tell you, I'm so excited to be back with this dry heat. I was in California and it was so muggy and humid.
It makes you appreciate it. You know, I was the same thing when I went to Tennessee. I'm like, oh, do people live like this? Yeah. And then I moved back. I'm like, oh, 98 and sunny. This is beautiful.
That muggy air that we've had here, though. I mean,
it's nothing.
Oh, no, it's nothing compared to it. But for a New Mexico boy, it's bad.
Humidity just feels different once you leave the state.
Yeah.
I was shorts, tank top, and still sweating, just dripping off, just like pouring off.
At least we get rain out of our humidity.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly.
All right,
Sunday. I'm out here for the balloon rally that gets underway here about 7, 8 a.m. 12 balloons going up today. We've got mass ascensions heading in our direction for the weekend. There's just so much going on here in Durango. If you've never been, first of all, it's themed this year. We're talking black tie affair. And we've got a full day of activities. There's a waiter and waitress kind of obstacle course going on. We also have bowling. We have a fireworks show tonight on Main Street. We also have the light parade. And if you've been before, you know the entire Southern Colorado area in Northwest New Mexico comes out to see this. It's a huge day. So we are going to be out here covering this live in front of the iconic Strader Hotel. So I'm going to be bringing more live updates, not only from here on Main Street, Street, but also out on the field where the balloons are set to launch
across the state. But even a little bit of moisture with the right amount of daytime heating can actually give way to some severe thunderstorms, and that's exactly what we had yesterday. Some of that moisture brought in by the cold front, daytime heating giving us the lift to fire off those thunderstorms, but it was only at across the eastern side of the state. Nobody else got those storms because we just didn't have the moisture. But this time of year,